Let's meet Klamath Bob.
Howdy. Name's Bob, but folks around here call me Klamath Bob. What can I do you for?
I think you're from Klamath?
Yeah, good old Klamath. Not a bad place if you like hunting, eating, and skinning geckos all day. It's a pretty dull place, but I hear there was a bit of excitement when this tribal from Arroyo came to town years back. All before my time, though.
Ah, yes. I remember the tribal from Arroyo. That happened in Fallout 2.
I might have some answers for you. What did you want to know?
What do you do around here?
I run the liquor store on Westside. With things this rough, some folks need a lot of booze just to step out of the door in the morning. After I close up shop, I walk around and help keep the peace. Not that I'm good with a gun, mind you, but someone's gotta do it, you know?
Yeah, I know. Things be dangerous around these parts. So, can you tell me about Westside?
Well, things aren't great here, but I've seen a lot worse. We've got the fiends to the south of us, and that ain't good. The scorpions hang out at the Monte Carlo when they aren't slinging chems or getting their heads blown off by the fiends. Probably the best thing we've got going on is the co-op, run by Mr. Etienne. Get some help from the followers of the apocalypse, I think.
Do you have a lot of run-ins with the fiends?
Not so much lately. The NCR is giving them hell anytime they poke their damn heads out. Bless those boys and gals for getting rid of that vermin. I feel pity for any man or woman that gets addicted to chems. But when they prey on decent folk, well, then it's time to put them down.
Like dogs. So, tell me about the scorpions. What happened to them?
Not much to tell. Typical gang of dumb bullies and angry nobodies. They're holed up a bit south of here, in the Monte Carlo suites. They think they're tough, but any time they tangle with the fiends, they get torn right up.
Ooh, like typical bullies. So, what's so great about the co-op?
Food from the people and for the people. Anyone can buy, but the profits are shared by the folks who make the produce. Locals got these little gardens that do real well. Gosh darn well, truth be told. Etienne got some help from that Anderson kid, I think. Anyway, we don't gotta rely on merchants so much. And it means the troopers can use all the food they make over on East Side. Works out nice.
Sounds like a very good deal. Enough about the West Side.
What else did you want to chat about?
Do you know anything about that super mutant out there walking around town?
Oh, yeah, that's mean son of a bitch. I know the name sounds bad, but he likes it. He's one nasty old coot. Far as I can tell, he's one of them original super mutants, what came from the Boneyard. Wandered about after that master fellow died. Eventually got caught somewhere around the hub back in NCR. Boy, they sure treated him mean down there. Cut him up so bad he can't talk no more. I tried to buy him just so they'd stop hurting him, but they didn't want any of it.
Oh dear, what a sad story. So, you know how did he get away from the NCR?
Turns out some of them night kids, whatever you call those sneaky super mutant types, got in and busted him out. I guess somebody named Tabitha led the bunch that freed him. Don't know much more than that.
Oh, you mean Nightkins. Yeah, I know those. I've met them. And Tabitha, That's the super mutant chick that runs the radio station up in Black Mountain. She's one crazy little lady, I'll tell you that. So, how did he end up here on Westside?
He just showed up here one day. Couldn't really talk, but he remembered me all right. Ever since then, he's just been, well, hanging around, I guess. Does odd jobs for folks and smashes the bad guys when they come poking around.
Nice! So, people around here aren't afraid of him? I mean, he's big and ugly.
Some folks steer clear of him, for sure, but you don't seem to mind.
Oh, well, I guess he's used to it. That could be worse.
What else did you want to chat about?
I don't have any more questions.
Sure.
So, see ya.
Okay, then.